when South Korean film Parasite became the first non-English film in 93 years to win the Oscar for Best Picture, its director Bong Joon-ho prodded audiences. Once you overcome the one-inch tall barrier of subtitles, you will be introduced to so many more amazing films. His win, along with the rise of OTT platforms, has shown the world that language is no barrier to commercial success. Money Heist was initially a Spanish crime drama that was subtitled in at least 27 languages. In the same way, Indian regional cinema also received the spotlight it always deserved. Jallikattu, a Malayalam film about a bull that escapes its butcher and creates chaos in a Kerala village, was India's official entry to the 2021 Oscars for Best International Feature Film. Arguably, regional cinema has always been superior to commercial Bollywood in terms of content. Hindi movies have won just 14 of the 70-plus national awards for Best Film. One man alone directed 5 of the 22 Bengali films nominated for Best Picture, Satyajit Ray. So it is no surprise that he is the only director of Indian origin who was awarded an honorary Oscar in 1992, just months before he passed.
I had to receive this magnificent award, certainly the best achievement of my movie-making career.
Bollywood producers, realizing the potential for novel stories in regional cinema, are remaking them into Hindi films, often almost screen for screen, and sometimes even with the same director. Sandeep Reddy Vanga directed both these films, and because the market for Hindi films is bigger, Bollywood ends up with bigger returns for adding zero creative value, something they have often been criticized for. If you ban Bollywood from copying South Indian, Korean and Hollywood movies and ban them from remaking old and new Hindi Punjabi songs, only 5 movies will be released in a year. Almost no creativity, always busy watching other films to buy the rights to remake them. Mediocrity is running at its best in Bollywood. Hindi version Rowdy Rathore earned 203 crore, 9 times that of the Telugu original Vikrama Kardu's 24 crore. Drishyam in Malayalam earned a stupendous 75 crore, but Drishyam in Hindi earned even more, 110 crore. Only earnings of the 2 Bahubali films combined have beaten this trend, grossing 2,460 crore, making more than India's highest grossing Hindi film Dangal. Producers in the 1980s and 90s often copied Hollywood movies in much the same way, but without permission. Hitch became Partner, A Star Is Born became Aashiqui 2, Breaking Away, Jo Jeeta Woh Sikandar, Happy Gilmore, Freaky Ali, and Mrs. Doubtfire became Chachi 420. But like everywhere else, cash is king. And even South filmmakers are no saints and have done their fair share of copying. The Hollywood film Memento was first copied in Tamil as Gajini and then in Hindi with the same name. Bollywood's Munna Bhai became Shankar Dada in Telugu. Bunty or Bubbly was also remade in Telugu as Bhale Dongalu and Three Idiots as Namban in Tamil, among others. Now that copyright acts are stronger, some buy the rights but don't even bother to change the title or even the creative. Dubbing regional movies into Hindi is another thing Bollywood does for money. Smaller producers make profits buying rights at low prices as these films are not given theatrical releases and meant only for TV audiences. The British introduced us to 3 things that have remained an abiding passion until now: cricket, the English language, and films. It was the era of silent films, 2 of which, Amazing Animals and The Life of Christ in 1906, mesmerized a young man in Bombay by the name of Dadasaheb Phalke. "This is so captivating, I too will learn how to make films." He bought a small Brownie camera which he filmed with, developing prints in a dark room, and watched movies every day. So much so that he almost became blind. He has developed cataract in both his eyes, a liability he overcame by wearing 3 to 4 spectacles one on top of another. Then mortgaging his insurance policies, he travelled to London. "I will learn everything about the craft." True to his word, when he came back to India with his Williamson 35mm camera, he made the silent film Raja Harishchandra in 1913, earning him the title Father of Indian Cinema. The first Indian film with sound though was Adesher Irani's Hindi film Alamara, who also made the first colour film Kisan Kanya in 1937. By the 1930s, India's storytellers were producing over 200 films per year, which rose to over 2000 in 2019. While 3 Hindi movies, Mother India, Salaam Bombay and Lagan, were nominated for the Academy Awards under Best Foreign Language Film, of the 53 entries sent by India, only 20 were non-Hindi, a clear case of bias by the Film Federation. While Mother India lost by a single vote, all five Indians who won Oscars have been outside of mainstream commercial Bollywood. Kolhapur-born Bhanu Athaiya won Best Costume Design for Gandhi. Chennai-born A.R. Rahman won two Oscars for Slumdog Millionaire, one of which he shared with Gulzar. And Kerala-born Resul Pukutti as Best Sound Engineer for the same film. Even the cult of a South Indian star is arguably larger than that of Bollywood. A new release by a South superstar is guaranteed to pack houses. So what if coronavirus is around? Thallapathy Vijay star A Master and Ravi Teja's Crack collected 158 and 60 crore in the first week respectively when theatres just opened. On the other hand, top Bollywood actors fared only averagely on OTT. Lakshmi Bomb's storytelling was too haphazard, Coolie No. 1's plot was out of sync with today's time, while Gulabo Sitabo was more appreciated by critics than by the audience. But well-crafted films like Ludo and Chintu Ka Birthday, with tight scripts and relatable storylines, impressed audiences. Regional cinema like Marathi movie Sai Raat, by grossing 110 crore, has shown it too can enter box office territory that until now only Hindi or South Indian films could do. Made on a budget of only 4 crore, it has been remade in 5 different Indian languages and rights have been bought for remakes in 3 more. Instances like this will be more common as more and more content will be made in languages, both in TV programming and streaming. Recently launched language-specific platforms like AHA, Telugu, Malayalam, Sun NXT for South Indian languages, Planet Marathi, City Shore TV Gujarati, Hoi Choi Bengali, Oli Plus Odia and Spool Bhojpuri are expected to give international OTT platforms a run for their money. Not only in movies, but also huge talent among regional writers is emerging with the advent of online publishing platforms. Looks like the one installed barrier of subtitles is being easily leapfrogged over by eager audience. Bizbo's Limerick. Regional movies are now being discovered, a gem of content that OTTs first uncovered. Copying screen for screen was the Bollywood machine. Now they got to work to fill their cupboard. Do join Bizbo on Discord and follow us on Instagram. Subscribe to Bizbo and click on the bell icon to get notified whenever Bizbo releases a new video. Sources of all our information is listed in the video description section.